All right, so can you guys do this calculation here? How many number of protons make 1 kg of protons? So you have, you're supposed to take this. If you guys don't want to do this now, do this as a homework and tell me the number of protons present in 1 kg of protons, okay? It's over here, the weight of the protons is given to you as 1 kg. You need to tell me how many protons, the number of protons that are present in 1 kg of protons, okay? So just take down the number, the mass of the proton, 1.67 into 10 to the power 24. And you have 1 kg of protons, so you need to tell me how many protons are present, okay? All right, let's do this question. Specific charge is defined as the ratio of charge to mass of a particle. Find the ratio of specific charge of an electron to proton. Yeah, all right, so it says specific charge is defined as the ratio of charge to mass of a particle. So if we want to find out the specific charge of an electron, what do we need? We need the charge of an electron and we need the mass of an electron. And then we need to divide these two things. So this is the charge of the electron and this is the mass of the electron. So I just have to divide this by this. So let's just do it for the electron first. So what do? I take the ratio of charge of an electron to the ratio of mass of an electron. That will give me the specific charge of an electron. All right, so this value is given to me on this page. Charge of an electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So I just wrote that down over here. And then mass of an electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 28, which I got from this. And I just put these two things over here. So all you have to do is put this over here and put this over here and divide these two things and then you will get specific charge. So it says CE by ME. This is nothing but your CE, charge of an electron. And this is mass of an electron, all right? So I'm just going to write it as mass of an electron. So this is in grams, this is in coulombs. Charge is in coulombs, mass is in grams. These are the units, okay? So I'm just going to put this in this formula and then I'm going to get minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 by 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 28. So what I'll do, I'm just going to take these two things and I'll simplify them. Minus 1.6 by 9.1. That's going to give me how much? 0.175 with a negative sign. Okay. So now I'm going to look at these two things. All right. So 10 power minus 90 is in the numerator. So I'm just going to write it as 10 power minus 19. And this 10 power minus 28, if I take it to the numerator, what happens? It becomes 10 power plus 28. Okay. Just writing that down again over here, minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, just as it is, into 10 to the power plus 28, because it has come from the numerator to the denominator. When it comes from the denominator to the numerator, the sign changes. So the sign has become positive. Yes, it's 9. So I'm going to just write this down as 9.1. And then over here, it will be minus 0.175 into 10 to the power plus 9. Okay, so if I simplify this, it is minus 1.75 into 10 to the power 8 coulomb per gram. Okay, cool. Now, can you guys do the same thing for protons? 1.6 divided by 1.67. So I'm just going to write this minus 10 to the power minus 19 on top. And then I'm just going to write this 10 power minus 24. The 10 power minus 24 goes to the numerator and becomes positive. All right, so I have 1.6 by 1.67 into 10 power minus 19 into 10 to the power plus 24. So 24 minus 19 is 5 plus 5. So then I'm going to write this as 1.6 divided by 1.67 into 10 to the power plus 5. So what is 1.6 divided by 1.67? This is 0.95 into 10 to the power 5. So, or I can write this as 9.5 into 10 to the power 4 coulomb per gram.